Hi everybody, today I'm going to be showing you guys how to make this fish charm. It is very easy to do, simple, and it's not hard to do, and you can just do it on one loom. And so you can use any colors you want. For this one, I used my mixed color bands. But today I'm going to be using a purple because I have a lot of this color. You might need more. And today for this whole thing, we're going to be using double bands. But some part around here we aren't going to. So, yeah. I'll tell you when we don't need to use double bands. But for all the rest, I think we pretty much have to. Okay, so let's get started. And of course, you're going to be needing your loom, a hook, your bands of your choice. And you're going to, you can use an S-clip or C-clip to tie this off, but I'm going to teach you how to make the little knot at the end. So don't worry about that. You don't need an S-clip or C-clip. Okay, well, let's get started. Okay, this time we're going to have our loom facing up, not this way, just to make it a little more clear and for you to know that the pegs are facing up, if you can see that. They're facing up. So, yeah. Okay, well, we're going to get started with using double bands. And, Okay, so we're going to go to the middle, to the left. Then we're going to go to the left, straight up. Now we're going to go up two more times, because that was one. Now we're going to go two, and then we're going to go three. So you're supposed to go up three times. So this is number two, and then this is number three. Double bands, by the way. Okay, now you went up three times. You are done. You can just push it down for that side. You don't have to touch it, but we will do something after. Now we're going to go to the middle to the right. We're not going to touch the middle section for now. We're just going to leave that be and do the sides. Now we're going to do the same length we did for this side. So it should be three, and it should be three here. So I'm just going to repeat this step with our colors. And right now, if you're wondering, we're just making the head part. If you want to make a different color for this part, I'm just saying, we're just making the head part, so, yeah. Okay, so now I have three on both of the sides, so both of the lengths are like the same. Now we're going to do the middle section, finally. Okay, so you might want to push down because we do have a lot of bands on this one. Well, we don't have a lot of bands, we just have the two double bands, but again, you know? Okay, so we're going to go up, and these are doubled. Then we are going to go up another time. And the third time. So we're going up three times. Just like that. So your loom should kind of just look like that. Now we're not going to be using double bands. We're going to be using just one band, a single band for this part. So, we're going to go in the middle, just like that. And this is one band, just saying. And then we're going to go up, so it should kind of be looking like a triangle shape. Then to close it off, we're going to get one band only. And we're going to close it up just like that. Oops, this band's going to break, it looks like. Okay, so, yeah. Okay, now this is how it should look like. These three bands right over here should be undoubled, and everything on the rest shouldn't be doubled. I mean, should be doubled. So this should all be doubled, except for these three bands, and that's the only thing that isn't supposed to be doubled, so. Let's get started and continue. Okay, sorry about that. We actually have just one more undoubled band, but this one's just like easy. You just go up, just like that. Okay, now the rest is doubled band. And, yeah. So, what we're gonna do is we're gonna go like this. And then we're going to get our other double bands. So this should be doubled, this part. And we're gonna go up. Okay, so now we're gonna get our other double bands again, and we're gonna go up just like that. And I'll show you from bird's eye view, just in case you cannot see it very well. Okay, so this is how it should look. Okay, now we're just gonna make the holding bands all together, so this is really important. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna twist a band like this. This is one option you can do. And then you make an upside down triangle, and then you have a double triangle, so it should be doubled. See? And another way you can do it is you can make one triangle at first. So, then just stretch it a little, twist it, and then put it upon itself just like that. But the way I like doing it is just with my hook, because I don't have to stretch, I don't have to, like, you know, it's just way more easier. And you only have to twist two times, by the way. So if you're doing it on your hook, you should only have two little slips there. And they should be upside down triangles. So then when you turn it around, they should be, like, up. So, yeah. And now we're going to do the same thing. But we're gonna do something a little different. Wait 1 second, sorry. For, not this one, all of these ones are the same, but we're gonna make something right here, but it's gonna be straight, it's not gonna be a triangle. And this time we're using double bands, and we're gonna go, sorry, you guys really need to see this part. We're gonna go here. To here, just like that. So it's gonna look like that, a little fishy. Okay, so now we're gonna start the easy, really easy triple link like hooking. So, yeah. So we're gonna go under our band. We're gonna catch those two bands, and we're gonna hook up, just like that. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're going to do the same thing. Oops, hook up. Okay, now we can go under this and go and make the triangle. Oops, sorry about that. Okay. So it's kind of like closing off the triangle. And then go under this side and get it and put it in. Oops. So there's a lot of stuff under this. Now finally we're gonna hook up the top band. So this isn't a single band. Now we're hooking the single bands, which is so hard because there's a lot of tension in this and your bands will probably break, but if they don't, good job. Oops. Sorry I skipped that part, but after that part, you would pretty much just keep on hooking up. And I hooked, I hooked this part going up. Now we're going to hook the middle. Sorry about that, guys. And then hook the middle up. So you should have something like this. Sorry about that flash. That was for our Instagram account. And then, sorry if my arm's in the way. You would just hook up, just like I'm doing. Try to go push back everything, get that bottom band, and just work yourself up. Sorry about the flashes. Okay. Okay, now you finished your whole bracelet. And now we are going to get our band. So, one band. And we're going to go under everything. And I'm going to teach you guys how to make the slip knot, which is super duper easy. Well, to my offense, it's very easy, but yeah. Oh my gosh. Ew. And you gotta make sure you go under all of that. Okay. Now you're gonna go under and just hold it. Tug it a little. So then you have that. And now you can take off your charm, and this part's gonna be really hard to take off. But you should take off the bottoms first. Well, that's what I do. I just work myself down to up. So, yeah, let's do this. Okay, so then you have your fish, goldfish, and mine turned out actually pretty long. I don't know what happened to it. Like, it's not that, like, look how different they are. That's weird. This one's, like, more of a circle, and this one's more like a, like, straight and stuff. But every little fishy has to be different, so I guess that's pretty cool how I made a skinny one and then, like, a more circled one. So, yeah. Comment, like, and subscribe if you like this. And, yeah. Okay, well, bye, guys. See you guys later for my next tutorial. I'm thinking about doing is teaching you guys how to make a winter hat. And here's a little glance of it. Very easy to do. I might teach you guys how to do that, but I don't know. But yeah, bye guys. Love you. And by the way, make sure to check out our Instagram channel. It's Loom Tutorials, LoomX Tutorials, and it's really good because it shows when we are posting things. So if you want to know, like, if you want to know when we're posting things, then go check it out right there. And, yeah, because then it will tell us, you guys, when we're making videos. And I might do this charm next, because I really like this charm. And, yeah, so, bye, guys.